Hello everybody, this is Dimple here again, welcoming y'all back to my next tutorial on Android framework components. So in today's video, we will see what is Android OTA updates. So what is an OTA update? OTA stands for over the air. Okay, so OTA updates are popular way of updating Android devices over the internet. Android devices can receive and install this over the air updates to the system and application software. Now there are hundreds of smartphone brands, right? So each phone manufacturer will release a smartphone with some operating system. Okay, so if there are any enhancement to that, or if there are any bug fixes or updating the Android operating system, all these things will be rolled out by these device owners in the form of OTA update. So any critical bug fixes or enhancements they make, right, these has to be provided to the customer, whoever is using that particular device. So in the form of OTA updates, this will be rolled out. So there are different types of OTA updates: non-AB OTA updates and AB OTA updates. Okay, these are the two different types. Under AB OTA updates, there is AB streaming and AB seamless updates. So we'll dig deeper and see what is non-AB and what is AB, and under AB updates, what is this streaming and seamless updates. To begin with, what are non-AB system updates? So this update mechanism was basically used in some older versions of Android, and it's also used in some of the devices which have limited flash size. Okay, so one important thing you'll have to remember is, in non-AB system, the device has only one copy of each partition. Okay, different partitions like system partition, boot partition, vendor partition, all this, there will be only one copy maintained. First, how this OTA update will happen? The device will check for new updates by regularly checking into the OTA server. So there will be one definite OTA server, and the device will keep continuously checking with that OTA server. Once the OTA update is available, the update package is downloaded to the cache or data partition. Okay, so it keeps continuously checking. When there is a new update available, that time the package will be downloaded to either cache partition or data partition. Then its signature is verified against the certificates which are already present in the device. So at this otacerts.zip file will be there. The certificates in this one are verified with the one which we are downloading from the OTA server. So once the download and verification are completed, the update is initiated using recovery system API. So in non-AB system updates, we use this recovery system API. This is nothing but a system API. It requires a caller to have Android permission recovery. Okay, so this recovery system.install package, this function will be called. When this function will be called, the device will be updated to higher versions. So non-AB system updates, one important thing, remember, there is only one copy of each partition, and basically we continuously keep checking with the OTA server, and using recovery system APIs, we update the device. And once the device boots into recovery, also verifies the signature of the package. So all this public keys, all this system certificate verifications are done. After everything, after all the verification, the boot partition, system partition, or the vendor partitions are updated. Okay, so recovery partition will not be created once the device boots into recovery. What will happen? Recovery partition will be part of the system partition. Once all the update is completed, then recovery partition will be generated. Okay, and the logs you can see at cache recovery last log. All the logs related to your system updates can be found here. So I hope you all understood what is non-AB system update. So it's used in older versions of Android. There is only one copy of the every partition in the device, and basically we use a recovery system APIs for that. okay. Next we'll see what is AB updates. Okay, AB updates, there are two types as I had already told, seamless update and streaming update. So first we'll see what is this AB seamless updates. So AB updates are introduced from Android Nougat onwards, and AB system keeps a duplicate copy of boot system vendor and other vendor specific partitions. Okay, there will be two copies. So if there is a boot partition in the device, there will be two boot partitions, there will be two system partitions like that. Okay, two copies are maintained. Recovery partition is no longer used since it was very similar to boot partition. Okay, now recovery partition will be part of your boot partition itself. So there is no separate recovery image or recovery partition. Keeping a duplicate copy of each partition will definitely take up the storage memory by two times, but it's really worth it because AB system contains AB partition called slots, okay, such as system A, system B. Your current slot is the active and bootable slot, and the update is applied to the inactive slot. So if anything goes wrong during the update, you can still continue to run the old operating system. So in non-AB system updates, what was happening? I was having only one partition, right? System partition, boot partition, recovery and vendor. All this I had only one copy. So if anything goes wrong, the device will be bricked. It will not be able to be recovered back. Okay. So to overcome that issue, AB updates was introduced here. Since we are having two partition, one partition will contain the old image, the current operating system image. So we are trying to flash in the other partition. If anything goes wrong, no worries, we are always rolled back to our current partition. So OTA updates can be applied while the system is still running. Okay, this is one more enhancement in AB seamless updates. When the system is running itself, we can apply OTA updates, as the updates will be applied on the inactive slot. Okay, so here you can see AB slot. So original state, we have partition A and partition B. Partition A is marked as active. Okay, now our OS will be running on this partition. Partition B is inactive right now. Now OTA update, when I download the OTA update, what will happen? Partition A is active and partition B will be inactive. So to inactive partition, all the packages are downloaded. The update happens in this particular B partition. So once the update is completed successfully, what will happen? Partition B will now become the active partition and partition A will become the inactive partition. They just switch once it is successfully updated. Suppose there is some problem and it is not updated, okay, that time what will happen? Partition A will remain active itself. Okay, so no data is lost, we are still having our OS. So AB system updates will use the update engine to apply all the updates. Okay, once the update is applied, device will be rebooted and the inactive slot will be marked as active and bootable. If the device boots successfully, the slot will be marked as successful. From then, the device will boot from this slot only. Okay. So this is one of the major advantage of AB updates. There is nothing we are losing. What is this update engine? Update engine is nothing but it's a background daemon used by AB system for the update process. So background daemon means the process which keeps continuously running in the background. So all this AB updates is done via update engine. Update engine will read the update package from the current slot and writes it to the other slot. So from one slot, it will read the packages and it will write it into other slot. Okay, once the update is applied, it marks the other slot as active and bootable. Okay, so here from partition A, it will read all the update packages and it will flash those packages on partition B. Once it is successful, it will mark partition B as active partition. So that is the function of update engine. Okay, we saw what is update engine. Next we will see What is this AB streaming updates? Okay, so we saw AB seamless updates. Seamless updates and streaming updates, the important difference is in seamless update, whatever package we are downloading, that will be saved on your device. Okay, so suppose your device do not have enough storage, that time we can use AB streaming updates. So what the streaming updates will do is it will not store any downloaded packages on your device. It will update it online. So AB system also supports streaming updates, which can allow your Android system to update the system as they are downloaded, so that they will not consume any space on your device. Okay, since full package doesn't need to be downloaded, you don't need the extra space that is allocated for a cache partition. Okay, so there is no cache partition needed. Updates can be streamed to AB devices, removing the need of downloading the package before installing it. Okay, the package need not be downloaded before we install it. Streaming means it's not necessary for the user to have enough free space to store the update package on data or cache partition. So what was happening in non-AB system updates, the full entire downloaded package would be stored either at data partition or cache partition, right? That will not happen in streaming updates. It will save user space. Okay, cache partition is no longer used to store OTA update packages, so there is no need to ensure cache partition is large enough for future updates. Okay, so this I have already told. If the device doesn't boot due to bad OTA or DM Verity issue, that time device can reboot into an older image. Okay, we saw non-AB system updates and we saw AB system updates. AB, there are two types, seamless and streaming. The only difference between those two is in seamless, what will happen? We download the entire package and we save it in our device. In streaming, what will happen? We do not want extra a disk or storage space on our device because it is installed as and when it is downloaded. Okay, that time we can, when our device don't have enough memory, we can go for AB streaming updates. So these are the things we saw. Now we'll see what are the benefits of this AB updates. So OTA updates can occur while the system is running without interrupting the user. Users can continue to use their device during the OTA. The only downtime during an update is when the device reboots into updated disk partition. Okay, in non-AB system updates, it would take a long time for the device to be updated. The reboot time was longer. But here in AB updates, what will happen? Both in seamless and streaming, when the system is running only without interrupting the user in the background, update will be happening. So after an update, rebooting will not take longer time. It will be similar to a regular reboot of the device. If an OTA fails to apply, user will not be affected. Okay, the device will not be bricked. The user will continue to run the old operating system. Okay, and we can reattempt the update again. If an OTA update is applied but it fails to boot, device will reboot back into the old partition and remains usable. Okay, the device will not be stuck in the boot screen. All those issues when you are flashing the device, you will not encounter such issues. Any errors affect only the unused partition set and can be retried. So such errors also become less likely because the IO load is deliberately low to avoid degrading the user experience. So input output load is also made low in this AB updates. So yeah, that's all I wanted to tell you all today. So OTA updates are basically triggered by the device manufacturers to fix some bugs, to roll out some bug fixes or any device update, operating system updating to the higher version. And we saw the different types, what is AB and what is non-AB and what are the advantages and disadvantages of each of them. So I hope this session was informative and helpful. Thanks everyone for watching this tutorial. I'll meet you all soon in my next tutorial. Until then, everyone take care. Bye.